It looks as though the Miami Dolphins will be going with Tua Tagovailoa as their starting quarterback in 2022. Who will his backup be? There has been plenty of turmoil and ambiguous reports swirling around the Miami Dolphins for the last week. The firing of Brian Flores has put the immediate future of the team in serious question, and the direction of the franchise is subject to change with a new regime in place. But the departure of Flores has apparently provided a solid answer to what we thought would be the biggest question mark of the offseason: Tua Tagovailoa's future as the starting quarterback. There is no real way to tell which reports are true and which may be part of a smear campaign, but it looks as though the Dolphins organization is no longer pursuing Deshaun Watson and will instead look to build around Tagovailoa. Rumor out of Miami has it that it was Flores who preferred the embattled Texans quarterback, and now that saga can finally be put to rest. The roster around Tagovailoa will need to be tweaked and filled out. Much of the focus on the off-season roster construction will be concentrated on the offense, and rightfully so. If the past 2 years and his injury history are any indication, then finding a worthy backup for Tua will be a high priority as well. The Dolphins will need to scrape together wins to make the playoffs in a tough division in 2022, and they can't afford a massive downgrade at quarterback should their starter have to miss any games. So who could the Miami Dolphins target this offseason to replace the infamous Jacoby Brissett? The front office will certainly be exploring both trades and free agency, but could the draft even be an option? Here are three routes that the Dolphins could be exploring this spring. Gardner Minshew. Minshew mania is long over, but the Eagles' backup quarterback can still provide the spark that made him a rookie sensation with the Jaguars back in 2019. He proved as much in 2021 when he was thrust into the starting spot in Week 13, completing 80% of his passes while throwing for 242 yards and 2 touchdowns with no interceptions. The Eagles were victorious over the Jets. Gardner Minshew and his aura can be described as Fitzmagic Ultra Light, as he comes from the same energetic mold as the former Dolphins quarterback. His teammates tend to rally around him in a similar fashion, and he has proven that he can lead his team to victories when given the chance. While his style of play might not match the game plan that the staff prepares for Tua, Minshew's ability to provide an offense with a shot in the arm could be something that Miami covets. Acquiring Minshew should be tough for any team that goes after him. Backup quarterbacks have become something of a premium during the COVID era, and Minshew is still under contract with the Eagles for another season. Since it is thought that Philadelphia is not 100% sold on Jalen Hurts as their future, they will likely demand a mid-round draft pick should anyone come calling. The Dolphins so own an extra fourth-round pick in the 2022 draft, so the necessary ammunition could be there. Marcus Mariota. If the Miami Dolphins choose to pursue a backup quarterback whose skill set can somewhat mirror Tagovailoa's, then they may want to take a hard look at Marcus Mariota. The locker room and quarterback room connections would be obvious. Mariota is a legend in his native Hawaii, and Tagovailoa had a poster of him on his wall growing up. They attended a throwing camp together when Tagovailoa was in fourth grade, and they both starred at St. Louis School in Honolulu. By all accounts, Mariota is a very positive locker room presence, and would bring a veteran ability to step in and be the starter should the situation arise. While he has not been a full-time starter since early in the 2019 season, he was still occasionally used in gadget plays for the Raiders over the last couple of seasons. In 2020, he started one game in place of Derek Carr, nearly leading Las Vegas to victory over the Chargers by passing for 226 yards and a touchdown. Mariota will be a free agent this coming offseason, and will likely have a handful of potential suitors. But the Dolphins could end up being the most attractive, and they have the money to spend to make a deal happen. We know that the franchise is not afraid to invest in a backup quarterback, given the $5 million total that they handed to Jacoby Brissett last year. Mariota's contract with the Raiders was worth $3.5 million, so Miami could give him a raise and still allocate the same money to backup quarterback. Could the Dolphins draft a quarterback? The 2022 draft may have one of the weakest quarterback classes that we have seen in recent memory. There are only a couple of prospects that are projected to be taken in the top 20, and none come in with an elite resume or scouting report. Luckily for Miami, they don't need a first-round quarterback, given that their draft pick will be no better than 25th this coming year. But if they are unable to nab themselves a legit backup in free agency or through trades, then they could be looking to pick one up with one of their mid-round selections. This situation is unlikely. The Dolphins will need someone with experience who is able to step in and lead a team that will have playoff aspirations, and a mid-round rookie is typically not the way to go. But we have seen it work before. The aforementioned Minshew was a sixth-round rookie when he threw 21 touchdowns and 6 interceptions, and we all remember when Kirk Cousins was selected in the fourth round by Washington in the same draft that they selected Robert Griffin the third second overall. The Miami Dolphins will certainly have other holes to fill with their draft capital, but there is a situation in which taking a quarterback with their fourth round selection might be the best move. If one of the prospects that is projected to be a second or third rounder, see, Carson Strong, Desmond Ridder, drops down to the 117th or 121st slots, then they could wind up being the backup in Miami in 2022.